local on the grounds, our Dream Guerrero, joining me, Mr. Kyle Ferruccio, as per usual, and welcome to the NAMM 2017 coverage. This is the last day of the NAMM show. Oh man, are we pooped?
My feet are so sore.
Yeah, right?
You're killing me.
It's a lot of stuff to see here, folks, but we finally narrowed it down to our favorite picks. So for this video, we're going to tell you guys what we thought was the best at the NAMM show. So first off, Kyle, what is your pick for best looking ukulele?
The best looking one, I think it has to be that the ukulele from Enya Music. Mm. They had their 5th anniversary, and it was a very aesthetically pleasing. Mm. They had like their, you know, their cutaway at the bottom again, and the headstock, just coupled with the color and the cut of wood. It was just gorgeous. Right. I thought it was beautiful.
Well, I'm pretty color biased, mostly because I've been here at the color booth for most of the time. So I really like, actually, the wall that we're at right now. All of the new Elite series are super sweet.
Kala, one of the Kala Elites was really pretty, but it had purple heart accents on it, and purple is my favorite color.
A beautiful ukulele by Naoki-san, Natural Ukuleles, and his detail and inlay is absolutely beautiful. Yeah, go check it out if you have a chance. It's a beautiful instrument.
Kanilea, the new 2017 Platinum. Very different from last year. It's very, very nice. Very nice design from Joel. Clara Walnut back and sides. Torrified Spruce top. Koa all over the place. Very beautiful.
So for me, I mean, people are going to judge me. They're going to be like, oh, you're such a Kanilea fanboy. But you know what? To be honest with you, and you know, it's not just me. You guys are going to hear a bunch of the other artists say it as well. But the most gorgeous uke on this floor right now, Kanilea EEV. Like, I don't know what they're calling it, but it's like the reforestation project.
As for Kanilea, they have this new model with like a bird on it. It's very, very pretty.
They're featuring the endangered birds series. That was pretty sick. It was really, really nice. The inlay work in there is nuts.
I gotta say, like the guys on it, Kanilea, kind of a benefit type of thing for sustainable forests. It's got an EEV inlay. It's crazy.
I love it. I love it so much. And every time I go hang out at the Kanilea booth, people are always touching it, looking at it, and playing it. It's a clear winner for me. So as far as best sounding ukulele.
Sounding.
So for my pick on best sounding ukulele, Custom Martin upstairs. But that comes with an asterisk, okay? So even though I believe it is the best sounding ukulele here, price tag on it is about $6,400.
Yeah.
Best sounding instrument, but you are definitely going to have to take out that car loan and pay for an ukulele instead. So that's my pick. It sounds amazing. Very bright, very loud. It's brand new. It's on the wall, but it sounds like it's aged like at least 10, 20 years already. So that's
Martin
my
man.
Pick for custom for best sounding ukulele here at the NAMM show.
So my best sounding one, it wasn't really an acoustic. I kind of went more of the electronics way.
Okay.
Just because I like hearing, you know, when people make really good pickups and they're able to, you know, relay the sound of the ukulele into the speakers pretty well. So I went with Godin.
Okay.
Just because I love their pickups and just the clarity that you get from the strings and the individual pickups on there. And I just think that, you know, they sound great. Yeah. And especially
did Godin have a new ukulele this year?
They didn't have a new ukulele, but I did plug in their old ukulele. Well, not old, but the ukulele they've always had.
Last year's ukulele.
And,
and
I think, you know, like in my opinion, maybe it's because they didn't have any way to innovate, you know, what's already like great sounding, you know, with their ukuleles.
Yeah.
So I think that was my pick.
Okay, so for best sounding of 2016, that was that's a good pick for. Nah, that's I'm just kidding. So now let's take a look at best accessory. What was your favorite accessory?
My accessory, it has to be that LR-Bag Synapse, the PA system. Even though it's expensive, I just can't get over that. Like everywhere I go, I'm looking at it and I just want one.
Yeah,
this is a good amp here. This is the LR-Bag Synapse. This range or the spread of sound, it's supposed to be like 180 degrees. Most amps are kind of directional, right? This spreads tone evenly throughout the entire room so that everybody in that range can hear clearly.
Also excited about the LR-Bag Synapse, which I think is really cool. It's a nice portable speaker, and that's going to be really expensive, but if you do a lot of gigging out and you don't want to have to bring a huge amount of like amplification gear. It will cover a 2,500 square foot space or 250 people.
The coolest thing that I've seen here in NAMM so far has to be that speaker by LR Bags. It's just like everything you would want in a one-piece speaker that you could bring to a gig. So I'm definitely putting that into my catalog for things my wish list that I want to have.
You know what? I must say the Synapse is pretty amazing. That was my close second because I played through the Synapse yesterday. And yeah. Had I had a little bit more time to kind of stew it over, maybe the Synapse. But just from the sheer volume of people saying magnetic tuner, that's going to have to go in favor of the magnetic tuner.
We just visited a booth called Klingon. Really cool stuff. It's a magnetic tuner.
Another thing is I seen a magnetic tuner you can put on a headstock.
The magnetic tuner. Did you see it?
Because it is a magnet. You can put it on the keys too, yeah, or any metal part of that.
They stick onto your ukulele using magnets. So it's really, really awesome. You can pretty much stick them on your tuners. You can also put the magnet wherever you want and connect it from there. I think that's really convenient for, especially if you're a musician, you get to choose where the tuners are actually going to stick out.
Star Trek. Klingon, yeah. Harry.
The Star Trek tuner.
All right, so bang for your buck. My bang for your buck, definitely Ohana. That light tenor that we had, that we played earlier, it's got that spruce top, Indian rosewood back and sides, slotted headstock. It's got everything that you could ever want in an ukulele. If that ukulele came out when I was starting out, that would have been my starting ukulele. At $329, at least that's what the MSRP that's over there right now. At $329, getting all that's a dream. So
and so I almost went with something kind of like that, but then I went to the Kala booth.
Okay.
But they have it's called Zirakoti wood. It's gorgeous. It's like a really dark wood. It's kind of like ebony, but not. It's just a different quality to it.
Okay.
And then they have a sapwood that's in the middle of it. And then also just because of the sound, it's a very hard wood, so it resonates like nobody's business. Mm. And then that coupled with their the LR Bags 5.0, I think the price is a little closer to 500, so a little more expensive. But I think if you're trying to go for the sound, and then for those of you that like to plug in and play, or the performers, I think like 550, like that's pretty dang good.
for
that sound, and then also just with the 5.0 pickup that like I mentioned earlier, it just sounds great.
That's a huge thing.
Yeah,
because like, I don't think that Ohana comes with a pickup.
So maybe with the pickup,
it might be about that same same kind of price. But right on. So innovative. So innovative. I save this for last only because as far as innovation goes, we didn't really quite see it in the ukuleles here.
Yeah, because different.
You know, I was thinking about naming the that Bugs gear that we tried out as kind of innovative, but that's been introduced in the earlier years. It just kind of made it better, so innovation really isn't there. So I was thinking about, as far as innovation goes, I put my pick with the Kala, that one with the checkered kind of wood, because they're doing is they're taking scrap wood and they're turning it into that top of that ukulele. So I feel that's innovative because all those scrap woods got to go somewhere,
And we saw a bunch of experimentation with different woods, but I think Kala like really found like that one little formula that works really well.
That Elite series. So Kala Elite series for innovative. So that one's got kind of an asterisk on it because as far as innovation, it's kind of a gray area. It is innovative, yes.
It's not like adding on something to the ukulele.
Right.
And that would be none other than the Romero Creations Tiny Tenors. It's a very innovative design. It's a tenor scale neck, but it's built to the same size as a concert ukulele. So bigger fretboard, but smaller size, more portable. But the body shape gives it a more rounded response. So you get a more even EQ instead of having a resonant frequency from the upper bout and lower bout. So what that translates to is when you plug it in, it gives you a much more controlled sound. You don't have to fight two frequencies and squash it with a para EQ. Just got one thing to deal with, gives you a nice even response.
I think one that comes to mind would be Blackbird Guitars. Their ukuleles, the Farallon particularly, which is their tenor linen-based ukulele. The body is actually made of linen and bio-based epoxy. That really struck me as amazing.
Blackbird, they came out with the Farallon a while back, but that is
one of the ukuleles to get. And for the price, it's like, it's a steal. One of the best sounding ukuleles I've heard, you know, besides the Clara.
I'm also really excited that Riza is here. They are steel string ukulele, so it's really cool because they've got that short ukulele scale. They have really great electronics. A lot of people have tried to make steel string ukuleles and failed. They've tried to bring them in as imports and the intonation's off. The electronics are off, but you're going to find that's not an issue with Riza. They have really great electronics, really great intonation.
So what was your most innovative?
I think my most innovative pick, again, I think it has to be the Risa.
Oh.
Risa with their electric ukuleles, yeah. Because there's a lot of companies trying to, you know, make electric looking ukuleles, yeah. But I think this one is purely just electric, you know, solid body. Mm-hmm. It's kind of like a Telecaster, yeah. With the steel strings and the playability, and it just sounds great. And I don't think I've tried many electric, you know, ukuleles that mm-hmm. just sound that good and are done that well.
Yeah.
And I think just as far as the innovation, you know, to scale down a Telecaster, you know, and make it work for ukulele, I think there's a lot more thought into it that I just can't.
Yeah.
I just play it, so I don't know.
So here's the wrap-up, guys. Best looking.
For me, it was the Enya ukulele, their five-year anniversary one.
For me, Kanilea Reforestation EV ukulele. It's
beautiful.
Best sounding ukulele.
Mine was the Goden ukulele, again, for the electronic pickups, not so much the acoustic.
For me, Custom Martin, hands down. All right, so best bang for your buck?
My best bang for the buck, it had to be that Kala Zero Cody tenor with the LR Bags pickup.
For me, Ohana tenor, spruce top, Indian rosewood back and side, slotted headstock, very light, very affordable, very awesome.
Yeah.
Most innovative?
Most innovative, it was the Risa, the electric ukuleles.
For me, Kala Elite Series, specifically the checkered pattern one. And best accessory?
Best accessory was the LR Bag Synapse. It's ridiculous.
For me, best accessory, Klingon Magnetic Tuner. Is there any notable ukes, though? Because, you know, we've said our favorite. There's so much ukuleles here, and there's so much things here at the NAMM show.
Yeah.
Is there any honorable mentions?
Well, I think this might be unfair, but yeah. Jake Shimabukuro's model.
Yeah, I was just going
to
say.
That is just like, you know.
There has to be room in this video
to avoid
mention.
Putting that in any of the categories, because yeah. That's, you know, that's ridiculous.
Yeah, Jake Shimabukuro model.
It looks good. It yeah. sounds good. Maybe not the most affordable for yeah. some of us, but.
Obviously, the new Jake Shimabukuro signature ukulele, which will be in production and available to the public. That's pretty cool.
Right now here at the Kamanka booth, the new Jake Shimabukuro model, that's going to be, I think it's going to be a factory model, so pretty much anybody can purchase it. So not, it's not just available to special dealers or anything. The public will be able to get their own customized ukulele with Jake's signature on it.
It's ridiculous.
So there were two honorable mentions for me. The Jake model, and the second one is the one from Kiwaya Ukuleles. It was the one that looks like the Gibson Songbird.
Oh, yeah.
So that, for me, those two ukuleles are my honorable mention. It's not by QY, it's by a custom maker. And you know what? Those two ukuleles could have made the list had it not been for the other ukuleles that I already put on the list. But any day, those ukuleles are top shelf.
Yeah, there's so many great ones out here.
Yeah.
But I think just like having to narrow it down and kind of, you know, yeah. pick, you know.
But those are our pick, guys. It's been such an amazing experience here at the NAMM Show. We enjoy it every single year that we're here. And that's why we love doing this for you folks, because we come out here and we want to be able to let you guys know what is, you know, what's the latest thing. And
what's going
on? We don't just enjoy seeing all the different ukuleles and seeing all the different accessories, but also seeing all our great friends, all our great musician friends non-musicians. We love all of you folks. We love seeing you guys here at the NAMM Show. So if you ever have a chance to make it out here, definitely come down to the NAMM Show. We'll, you know, you'll feel like home. So thank you guys so much for watching our NAMM 2017 coverage. This is Aldrin Guerrero.
Kyle Ferruccio.
See you folks next time. Aloha.
Shirts.